Is that the green?
Yeah.
So now I've been, ever since I met you, Tyler, 2 years ago now, I've of course been a huge fan of Down with Webster and the music, but you know, you guys have such a unique kind of story. You've been together for 16 years now.
Yeah.
And you guys are only 22, so that's crazy. No, but you guys came together, what, in junior high, right?
Yeah, grade 8.
That's so weird. So weird that we've been together.
And I think maybe not all six of you, but...
It was Pat and I, and then like I was playing T-ball with Bucky, and like, we were all kind of like in the same little neighborhood.
his dad was our coach.
And then by, I think, what, like grade 10, we were all kind of doing it.
So it's literally been...
It's been a long
time. Actual band. Yeah, you were kids.
I don't think there's many bands that have been together as long as us. Came from you.
You guys are so well known in Canada. I mean, you're nominated for awards with, you know, Avril Lavigne and like huge other big Canadian artists and pop artists. But yet, it's a different story now when you come to the U.S.
Yeah.
So what's that dynamic like of being in your home country, being, you know, where recognized all the time, and huge, huge shows, and winning awards, and you know, nominated all these huge award shows, and then you're in the U.S. and it's a different story. I mean, obviously you're getting more well known, but it's
humbling, and it's, I think it's a good thing for us. I mean, like playing those like small, sweaty shows and getting to like build your fan base one kid at a time. It's like a very exciting thing. It's frustrating at times because, you know, the style of life on the road is way different. We're touring right now in like, you know, a white passenger van and we're driving it ourselves. And then back up in Canada, we'll get on a bus again with a crew of like 8 or 9 people. Well, that, I think it keeps it fresh for us.
It's like where we started was doing like these kind of shows. So it's like always fun to like go back and like, you know, feel that kind of energy again, where as opposed to like you're standing on a big stage 10 feet away from the front row, like these shows that we're playing here, it's like I'm in the crowd with people, like jamming with them. So that's like always like a really fun part of it.
It's also one of those things that even when we were doing tiny little clubs in Canada before anyone knew us, we tried to build the show like it was a stadium show, like it was a big, huge arena. And so even if we were playing for like, you know, 50 kids in a tiny, sweaty club in Ontario, we kind of have the same energy on stage.
Visions of grandeur.
So now it's like, we're like, oh wow, I can't bring all my amps down because we're on a tiny little stage, but the show is kind of the same as it was back then.
The Beck Barrows Steel.
Yeah. All right.
It's a cilantro garnish.
It's not blue, but it's green.
This is green. The light from the left for you.
I feel like all you guys need drinks too.
You need some.
So good.
All right, well.
Share the wall.
Blinky.
Drinks for everyone in the restaurant.
Yes. Happy birthday, Kelly.
And happy birthday.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah. All right.
Thanks, guys.
Let's go for
cheers.
It.
Cheers.
I'll fuck that all day. Ooh, that spice.
I know you guys are starving because of your crazy long drive.
Wow.
In your van.
We had Dunkin' Donuts at 9 a.m.
I had that big and toasty. It's pretty big and toasty.
Really? I haven't had one of those yet.
Oh my goodness.
Look awful.
We don't have Dunkin' Donuts in Canada.
Yeah.
We don't have that.
But you have Tim Hortons and it's way better.
Yes.
I'd rather not be choosing either.
Yeah.
If it really kicked
out. Wish you had both whenever you wanted.
I think
we should move on to dinner, guys. What do you think? You guys hungry?
Yeah.
All right.
So I have some food for you.
Ooh, nice.
Of course. Oh, wow. So we have our roasted beet carpaccio with hazelnuts and a little mound of arugula and parmesan.
Yum.
These are the bay scallops and veal sweetbreads, lightly fried.
What?
With a truffled lemon aioli. Also, there's wasabi infused tobiko and fresh pea shoots on the plate. And then this is our sea scallop crudo with shaved radish beets, little grapefruit segments, and celery.
Aren't they beautiful?
It looks so pretty. I don't want to
eat it.
I want to take a picture.
Okay.
you're gonna do the
phone. You want to Instagram?
Yeah, the Instagram. You
want to Instagram? Okay, so
I'm gonna say that I did it.
So all right, here's the thing. Yeah. So I know Pat doesn't like to be picky, but being the vegetarian that he is. Or is it
wah, wah, right?
I know, right? Well, so what's so cool about this restaurant is that so many of their dishes are vegetarian or vegetarian friendly, but they don't feel like veggie dishes. Like, look, like that's a carpaccio. It almost looks like steak carpaccio, but it's not. It's beets. Oh. And then same thing with, so the scallops over here. Look, I mean, they slice them so thin.
Yeah,
but you do eat seafood, right,
Pat? I'm pescatarian.
Okay, you're a pescatarian.
Yeah, so there we go.
Okay, yeah. Great. So these scallops are very, very light, amazing, and made with.
Where's the scallop?
So
it's the white.
It's literally,
it's, the white.
It's
you can
so
barely
thin.
See it. It's the bottom.
It's all,
so it's all in between the other things.
Yes, yeah, like shaved scallops. Yeah, and so you might not want to dig into the sweetbreads, which is great because it leaves more for the rest of us.
What's a sweetbread?
I'm glad you asked, Tyler. No, so sweetbreads are, it's a very euphemistic name. Have you had sweetbreads before, Bucky?
No.
Okay, well this is
and
very exciting for me that,
big
I,
words.
That I get to have you try sweetbreads for your first time. So they're the thymus gland of either a lamb or a calf.
Yes.
So I'm not sure. I think these are lamb sweetbreads.
Where's that gland?
So basically, it's like in the throat.
Sweet.
So it's not like some weird
lamb throat. Let's
do it.
Not
weird at all.
Right, but they're delicious, and you have to prepare them very delicately. And a lot of restaurants screw it up. And FMK does an amazing job with sweetbreads, and it's mixed in with scallops too. So it's almost kind of like a fried dish that, let's say, for somebody that maybe likes chicken McNuggets or something. Can easily adapt to this dish.
The guy with the bib.
Bring it on.
Oh my God, look at you, I love it. All right, hey, let's dig in. So here, let's start passing some stuff around.
Right.
Here, we'll hand these to Pat first.
Yeah, yes. Pat, you go in on
okay.
that.
Mr. Pescatarian over
pass
there.
Pass me these throat.
I will, right off the plate.
Mm. Yeah, I know the chef here said this is one of their signature things. Because at I wasn't thinking of ordering these, and then he was like, you have to get the fingerling potatoes.
Yeah.
I haven't had these here yet. They're amazing. So the fact that Bucky just said this might be one of the best restaurants he's ever eaten at.
Well, actually, it's a big compliment.
These
you
guys travel all over the place.
Great food in Toronto. Mm-hmm. I've been to your fair city many, many times. I've been to you guys. Enjoy the rest of your meal, all right?
No,
already bukoing the dinner table here. All right?
Cheers. All right, baby. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Well, I think we have a few more drinks coming.
Wait, and what about dessert?
Maybe some dessert?
We need a little dessert here.
As long as there's no candles, as long as there's no candles, we will have dessert.
Sparklers,
I'm fine with.
Yeah.
Fireball.
Cheers, boys. Cheers. I cannot wait for the show. You guys are gonna kill it on stage tomorrow. I'm so pumped with my only three friends that I can bring.
Three and a half.
Okay.
You can bring Howard. I'm just eating all your food. Your food.
He's gonna hold it up on a stick.
Yeah, he's paying.
And cut. You get it when you walk out. It's it holds up to 12
people. You maybe credit it to the center? Or,
yeah.
This is the best place.
I can't believe you're not eating that.
I had four of them already.